शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मुक्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं विदागच्छ प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदा प्रकाशमोक्षिर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्मनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महा तदेवान्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सॉरी आई एम हैविंग सम स्क्रीन ट्रबल हियर। इज द स्क्रीन स्टिल विजिबल और नाउ विजिबल?
नो।
It is visible.
Visible, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So we saw that the Srishti Krama has no tatparya of the Shruti. It is done for Manda Adhikaris and it helps them in the Krama helps them in reversing it to resolve into Atma, resolve the entire Srishta Prapancha into Atma. Further, Shrityukta Utpatti Krama Nirupanam. Now this Krama is described further. Prasangat Maya Swarupa Pratipadanam. Maya is the reason that there is Srishti. Without Maya, Nirguna Brahma cannot create. So this is Maya which is inferred. We saw Karyanumeya Maya. So Maya Swarupa is described in Prasanga, in the context, since without Maya you cannot explain Srishti, therefore Maya is brought about. Maya Swarupam Jiveshwaradi Vibhaga Shunya Shuddha Chaitanya Shrita Maya. So Brahma Shrita Maya, Chaitanya Shrita Maya. Maya is not independent. Although Maya has to be inferred, cannot be independent. Is resting upon same Brahma which is Chaitanya and Shuddha Chaitanya. By association with Maya, Shuddha Chaitanya becomes Ishvara. Jiveshwaradi Vibhaga Shunya. The Shuddha Chaitanya does not have Vibhaga of Jiva or Ishvara. Of course, Ishvara is Shuddha Brahma or Nirguna Brahma, but so is Jiva. So people who say that Ishvara is nothing but Nirguna Brahma, they should complete the sentence by saying so is Jiva. Jiva is also Shuddha Chaitanya, Nirguna Brahma. So what is the difference? The difference is definitely in the Upadhi. One Upadhi is something that one wants to get away from. The other Upadhi is something that one can never get. Ishvara's Upadhi cannot be earned. One can get Hiranya Garbham, which is similar to Ishvara Upadhi, but without any control. There is no control, there is no creative activity there. There is no sustenance, there is no destruction. I mean, the maintenance of the Prapancha is in the hands of Ishvara due to that Upadhi. Hiranyagarbha has the Upadhi which can be earned by Upasana, Karma and Upasana, leading to Atyanta Sukha, but which is Anitya. So all the Upadhi Sukhas put together is the Hiranyagarbha Sukha. If one craves for that kind of Sukha, one can earn it across many Janmas, not easy, through Karma and Upasana. But Ishwarattvam cannot be there. Ishwarattvam in a sense, you cannot replace Ishvara. So Jivattva Bhava is what one wants to get away from. Therefore, it is not becoming Ishvara, it is going beyond the Upadhi, including the Upadhi of Ishvara. So Jiveshwaradi Vibhaga Shunya Shuddha Chaitanya becomes an ashraya for Maya, and the same Maya starts dividing this Shuddha Chaitanya into Jiva, Ishvara, Prapancha, Ityadi, all the Bhedas. So Brahma becomes Shabalita, variegated. So Maya is really, if we, when we say that Ishvara is the creator, but even the creator of that Ishvaratvam, not Ishvara, Ishvaratvam is Maya, which itself has no presence. So it's a very very convoluted thing. Without Brahma, Maya has no existence, and Ishvara has no presence, Jiva has no presence, Prapancha has no presence without Maya. We say without Chaitanya, yes, but without Chaitanya, Maya itself cannot exist, and without the Chaitanya and Maya, Chaitanya is assumed there. So what is the Vishesha Karana? Vishesha Karana has to be Maya, which creates Ishvara and Jiva Bheda. Iyam Utpatti Raitatvad Anadihi. So Iyam Maya Anadihi. Why is Maya considered to be Anadi? First of all, Maya is inferred. Now in the inference also you cannot say that it has come about at some point of time. Why? Tasyaha Utpatyangi Kare Putrat Pituhu Utpatti Kathanasya Iva Maya Karyat Prapanchat Mayotpatti Kathanam Asangatam Bhavet. If we consider Maya as having a beginning, then it would be like the father being born out of the son. As though. Because Maya Karyat Prapanchat Mayotpatti Kathanam Asangatam Bhavet. Because when you say something is in time, that time is itself in Prapancha. In time something came about. So when you say that, that Kala is from the perspective of the Prapancha. That Prapancha which is born out of Maya. How can Maya come about in time, in the time of the Prapancha, in the context of the Prapancha? So the source for Prapancha cannot have a beginning in the timeline of the Prapancha. Tasma Chaitanyat Mayotpatti Mayotpatti Vaktavya. So Mayotpattihi Vaktavya. You have to talk about this Mayotpatti from Chaitanya now. Tathasati Jivatva Ishvaratvayor Maya Karyatvat Na Jiva Chetanat Na Vish Nava Ishvarat Chetanat Mayotpattir Bhavet. If you consider Maya has come about in time, then where has it come about from? Oh, it's not from Prapancha, from Chaitanya. We say it has come about from Chaitanya. If it is so, then Tathasati, if Maya has taken birth at source being Chaitanya, then Tathasati Jivatva Ishvaratva Yor Maya Karyatvat. Jivatva and Ishvaratva itself is Maya Karya. Na Jiva Chetanat Na Va Ishvara Chetanat Mayotpattir Bhavet. Then which Chaitanya is Maya born from? Is it from Jivatva which is born out of Maya? Is it from the Chaitanya which backs Jivatvam, or from Chaitanya which backs Ishvaratvam? Both are same, but since you are technically analyzing it, then the question will be which Chaitanya? Jiva Chaitanya or Ishvara Chaitanya? Chetana. Chetana Chaitanya, same meaning. Mayotpattir na bhavet. Meaning, it is not possible from Chaitanya, Jiveshwara Siddhau Tatsakashat Mayotpattir Maya Siddhau Jiveshwara Siddhir Ityanyonyashre Prasangat. Because Shuddha Chaitanya cannot do anything. There is some upadhi needed for some creation. So if we say Chaitanya becomes the Karana for Mayotpatti, then why do you need Maya at all? You can use Prapanchotpatti from Shuddha Chaitanya. The very reason that we brought in Maya, Shruti brings in Maya, is because Shuddha Chaitanya cannot be the Karana for anything, cannot be the source for anything. Now, having brought in Maya, then we question where from this Maya came about. Then we have to talk about Chaitanya, because nothing else is there. If we talk about Chaitanya, that Nirguna Chaitanya cannot be Karana. Otherwise, we are back to square one. So we have to say Jiva Chaitanya or Ishvara Chaitanya, which is later. Later in the sense, there is an Upadhi. Or a Visheshana also. We can keep it a little loose. We say that the Jiva Upadhi Avachinna Chaitanya or the Ishvara Upadhi Avachinna Chaitanya. Antakkarana Upahita Chaitanya. If we say that, then that itself is Maya Karya. And Maya comes about from that. So there is mutual dependence, Anyonyashraya. That's a dosha. Therefore, Shuddha Chaitanyam to Asangam Akriyam Avikari cha. Being Avikari, Akriya and Asanga, Shuddha Chaitanya is not the Karana. And if you take Jiva Chaitanya or Ishvara Chaitanya as Karana, there is Anyonyashraya. So we have trouble any which way you try to understand. Understanding Maya is very difficult. Kincha yadi Shuddha Chaitanyat Mayotpatti ruchyate tarihi mokshadashayam Shuddha Chaitanyasya sattvat punar Mayotpatti prasangasyat. Further, if you think that, okay, I don't want to have Anyonyashraya. Tarkika says Anyonyashraya. Let's not talk about that. It's a flaw. We consider it as a flaw. Let's say that Shuddha Chaitanya is the Karana. If Shuddha Chaitanya is the Karana, there is a further issue. Moksha will become impossible. How so? Moksha dashayam Shuddha Chaitanyasya sattvat. Is Shuddha Chaitanya there before the Utpatti of Maya? Yes. Because we have said Karya comes from Karana, Karana has to be there. Karana is Shuddha Chaitanya. So if we discuss Maya Utpatti from Shuddha Chaitanya is present. And that same Shuddha Chaitanya is present after Moksha also, Moksha Dashayam. Then what is the difference between the two? Maya can come up again. Maya, which had a beginning, had birth from Shuddha Chaitanya, can have a birth again in Moksha Dasha also. Because of what reason? Shuddha Chaitanya Sattvat. So Shuddha Chaitanya cannot become Karana, not only because it is Nirguna Ityadi, Akriya, Sangha, Avikari Ityadi, but also Moksha will become impossible if you say that, okay, I mean, I don't want to get into details, but let's assume that it is a Karana. So Maya need not be brought in. That is the first thing which you have mentioned. Then if you still bring in, there are logical flaws of Asangatvam, Akriyatvam, Avikarityam going for a toss, because they are meaningless words. Can still become a Karana. If you still say, okay, I'll ignore those, Moksha will be impossible. There we have trouble because Moksha is something that we are pursuing. And if Moksha is going to be impossible, because Maya can crop up again, then Moksha will be in Anitya. Anitya Moksha is no Moksha. It is like the Dvaitin's Moksha. Anitya. Therefore, Kincha, Yadi Shuddha Chaitanyat Mayotpatti Ruchyate Tarhi Moksha Dashayam Shuddha Chaitanyasya Sattvat Punar Mayotpatti Prasangasyat Moksha Sadhana Vayyarchincha Syat. Entire effort is having no purpose, therefore a wasteful exercise. Tasmat mayotpattir ahita. So Maya has to be considered as anadi. You cannot talk about mayotpatti. Ata evacha anadihi. since Utpatti cannot be discussed, all sorts of laws crop up when you discuss Maya Utpatti, inquiring to Maya Utpatti. Therefore, vicharam na sahate. Either you will go mad or Maya cannot be accounted for at all. And since Maya cannot be accounted for, none of the karya can be accounted for. If you start inquiring into it, either one will get lost and go away from Brahma, or if the inquiry is appropriate, then Maya itself will not stand scrutiny. Maya karya will also drop off on its own, and one will rest in Shuddha Chaitanya as one's own Swarupa. Sacha Eka Eva. Now this Maya is one. We don't need to talk about many Mayas. Jnana Nashyatvat Santacha. If the question is Anadi, nothing which is Anadi goes away in time. If that is a question, no, it will go away in time because Jnana Nashyatvat. So Tarkikas explain it because there is no example otherwise. Example of something which is anadi and santa. Santa means antaya sa vartate. Antam sa vartate. Anta is to be there. Antena sa vartate iti santa. That which will come to an end. So that which has no beginning but comes to an end. That is a tarkika example as to the pragabhava. Pragabhava of a ghata. Ghata, prior absence. Ghata does not, abhava is a padartha, okay. You have to take Tarkika's terminology. You cannot mix up terminologies. You have to be a purist when you use whichever word. So Tarkika's example, because this is Tarka. How can anadi be a santa? If that's a question, yes, praga bhava is a padartha. We don't agree with it. But if a Tarkika asks a question, Tarkika should be replied in his own jargon. So, of course, Tarkika will not ask a question as to Anadi, how can it be Santa? Because he knows his own example. These are their own examples. That Pragabhav of a Ghata. Ghata has Ghatattvam. That Ghata comes into being in time. Before the Ghata came into time, what was there? There was Ghatasya Pragabhav. Ghata was, we shouldn't say Ghata was absent. Ghata had prior absence. So we'll say there was prior absence of Ghata. So Ghatatva Abhava was there. Abhava is a Padartha. Now that Ghata, Pragabhava is a Padartha which was there. When was it there? It was ever there. Had it not been there, then Ghata cannot come about. If the Ghata is there, then Ghata and Ghata's Ghata Abhava cannot be together. So Ghata Abhava was there Anadi Kalena. Ghatabhava, which Pragabhava, Ghatasya Pragabhava, Ghatapragabhava is Anadihi. As soon as Ghata is made, then Ghatapragabhava cannot coexist with Ghata. So Ghatapragabhava goes away, Nashyate. Therefore, so that goes away. Thereby, we have an example to establish that anadi can be santa. So maya, anadi, but santa. Eka is to be inquired into, but we don't need another. Unless we need another maya, we should not bring about gauravam. So laghavam is there, ekaya. Maya is one shakti. Why should we talk about many shaktis with similar characteristics? It's one shakti. Seyam maya sarasad vilakshana. This maya is sadvilakshana and asadvilakshana. Trikala badhyam yat tat sadityuchyate. So sadvilakshana, if you say, then what is sat? Sat is trikala avadhyam. That which cannot be negated, sublated in any period of time, that is sat. So this is the definition of sat. Is maya sat? No. Maya jnana nashyatvat santa. So it will come to an end. After jnanotpatti, maya will be sublated. Therefore, cognitively negated. Sublated is cognitively negated. That is what is mentioned by Badha. Badhya Shabdena nashyatvam uchyate, that is sublation cognitively. Trikala abadhyatva chaitanyam sat. Chaitanya cannot be negated at all because the negator and the negated both are resting upon the same chaitanya. Cannot be negated at all. So there cannot be chaitanya badha. Therefore, chaitanyasya abadhyatvat trikala abadhyatvat chaitanyam sat. Chaitanyam sat, chaitanyam eva sat. Chaitanya alone is sat. Now this maya is santa, therefore badhyatvam is there. Maya tu jnana badhyatvat sadvilakshana, therefore maya is different from sat. Can it be said to be asat then? In one way it can be said to be asat if you interpret the nunch properly. The nunch can be of six types, but not asat in the sense of completely absent. Kalatreyapi apratiyamanam shashashrungavat. Sorry, kalatreyapi apratiyamanam shashashrunga vandhya suta akasha padmadikam asad ityuchyate. What is asad? Generally, when you say asad, then abhavarthe nanj is assumed, unless explained. Ajnana is explained as not being abhavarthe nanj. So here, if you say asat, unless you explain, it is abhavarthe nanj. And if it is abhava of sat, completely absent, so sat is kalatraya abadhya. And kalatraya api yasya badha yasya pratijirna bhavet. That will be asat. Tad asat. In no period of time would you have cognize something that will be called as asat, such as shashashrunga, rabbit's horn, vandhyasuta. So, child of a barren woman who never had a child, there cannot be a child. Akasha padma, there was never an akasha in a padma, a lotus seen in akasha, never, in no period of time. So, these are the examples. Adhikam asad ityuchyate, that is asat. Is maya asat? No, because maya karya is known. Without maya karya cannot be there. Jnanat purvam maya tat karyam cha pratiyate. You see the underlying force working. Even in science, they infer something out of an experimentation because karya is seen. Karya is known. Karana is not cognized grossly. It has to be inferred through the experimentation. So, jnanat purvam maya pratiyate, tat karyam cha pratiyate. Tatahi, therefore, it is not asat. Maya is not sat, so sadvilakshana, and not asat, therefore asadvilakshana. Tatahi jagrat kale aham ajnyah brahmana janami ityanubhuyate maya. How do you know maya exists? How do you infer maya? How do you, from karya you infer maya, but how is the anubhava of maya? Maya anubhava is in this manner, jnanat purvam. Jagrat kale, in the waking state, aham ajnyo brahmana janami. I do not know brahma, says the ajnani. Iti anubhuyate maya, I do not know brahma. He may not say, there is an anubhava. I do not know maya. I do not know brahma. That is maya. Because the avarana is anubhuta. Vikshepa is anubhuta. That is maya. There is nothing other than that which is called as maya. Trigunatmika maya. How is it known? Through the gunas. The gunas are not the karana of maya. Gunas themselves are maya in a particular assembly, particular formation. That trigunatmika maya means trigunam atma or trigunaha atma guna. So the triad of gunas, that itself is atma. Atma there is swarupam. Atma swarupam yasyaha sa trigunatmika. So these three gunas are the very swarup of Maya. Maya has no presence other than gunas. Is it made up of gunas? No, gunas themselves are Maya. So when you have avarna, when tamas is working, tamas is known with avarna. With rajas, vikshepa is seen. Sattva, which helps the jnanatmaka vritti to come about. Sorry, vrittyatmaka jnana to come about. So the shakti manifests in all three ways. It veils through tamas. Makes you active, resolve the issues, come out of tamas through rajas. And both are countered and transgressed through inquiry with jnana shakti, which is a manifestation of sattva. So when one says that brahma, aham brahmana janami, one may not say that, but there is an anubhava that I do not know. One knows oneself as something other than brahma. That is the brahmana aham na janami. I see myself as a limited being, as a man, as a teacher, a student, an engineer, blue collar worker, white collar worker, whatever it is, as a parent, as a child, all these are associations with the body, mind, sense complex, which itself is brahma aham na janami iti anubhuyate maya swapna kale pratiyamana sarva padarthanam upadana karanataya maya eva vibhati. And in swapna, what is the manifested prapancha? It is all what is pratiyamana sarva padarthanam upadana karanataya maya eva vibhati. The material cause for the waking world components, objects, can be inquired into, and you will have many. It's not easily solvable. But when you wake up from swapna and you compare the swapna world during the swapna, it will have the same issues as waking. You cannot come to one cause. You will see as many causes for many objects. But when you wake up, you know that there cannot have been, there couldn't have been many causes. There was no world which was really present. It was all manifest from the same underlying principle, which happens to be Maya here. Avidya. Finally, it will be equated with avidya. This maya eva vibhati. Katham? Upadana karanataya. As the upadana karana, as the material cause of the swapna prapancha padarthas. Meaning prapancha. Suptothitasya sukhamaham asvapsam nakinchid avedisham iti paramarshaha smritihi bhavati. Paramarshaya smriti. One wakes up from deep sleep now. In deep sleep, this maya karya isn't there. Vikshepa isn't there. What about avarna? Avarna is there. Nakinchid avedisham. I did not know anything during deep sleep, says the person who has woken up. Suptothitasya smritihi katham bhavati iti bhavati. Aham nakinchid avedisham. I did not know anything. And still there is Chaitanya Sukha also. Atma Sukha is there. Sukamaham Aswapsam. Therefore, one slept blissfully. One wakes up to say, I slept blissfully. Didn't have any dream. Meaning one does not recollect any dream. During that part of deep sleep, there was no dream. Therefore, slept blissfully and then did not know anything. Slept like a log. This is avarna. This is the swarupa manifested. Our focus is na kinchit avedisham sacha smriti ananubhutearthena sambhavet. You cannot have smriti, waker cannot have a smriti unless there is anubhava. It's a recollection. Recollection cannot be possible unless there is collection. So when did the collection of this experience take place? It was when it was being experienced, and that has to be during deep sleep because the expression is about deep sleep. So during the deep sleep, it has to infer that there was collection of this into memory experience that happens to be I did not know anything and I slept blissfully. This ananda anubhava and ajnata, nothing is jnata, that is also na kinchid avedisham, that anubhava is registered. When one wakes up, then he recollects. Therefore, ananubhutyarthena sambhavet sacha paramarshat smriti here. The reason smriti seems to be added is because sa has been used here. Paramarshaha is pullinga, smriti is strilinga, sacha smriti, because he said smriti. Of course, paramarsha smriti, that's how the sadhu has used this. Saha paramarsha, sorry, yaha paramarshaha shushupti dashayam sa smriti reva. So, vidhe pradhanyena strilinga sa. To resolve that, explain that, smriti has been put in the bracket because sacha smriti, where is the smriti? Paramarsha smriti hi. There in samanadhikaranyam, even if there is linga veda. Tasma shushuptava jnana anubhava asti. So, shushupti brings about this avarana anubhava. Ajnanam maya iti cha ekameva vastu uchyate. And that avarana ajnana karya. Just give me one moment, please. Sorry. Sacha, sorry. Ajnanam maya iti cha ekameva vastu uchyate. Ajnana and maya, avidya, maya, these are different terms for the same entity, which is bhava padartha. Just like you cannot say maya is non-existent, you cannot say ajnana is non-existent. Ajnana is not absence of jnana. The term ignorance is used for the lack of a better word in English. You cannot have a single word replacement for ajnana or avidya. Once ajnana is understood, it's preferable to use the word ajnana or avidya instead of using ignorance, because ignorance has a completely different and erroneous connotation. Should not be used. But unfortunately, teaching being in English, it's very difficult to mix up. So, ignorance registers as the word, a translation for avidya or ajnana, which is completely erroneous. This is the reason people think that, you know, they don't even know the logical flaw of ignorance, absence of something being a cause for something else. Then they have to work around and say, oh, ajnana is not the karana, maya is the karana. You have to differentiate ajnana and maya. Still, we have to account ajnana. So something which is absent has to be accounted for. It is ridiculous. It has a lot of flaws. So ajnana as an abhava padartha is meaningless. It need not be talked about. It is like talking about shunya. The entire philosophy is based on shunya. This is not shunyavada. People who talk about ajnana as different from maya and non-existent, therefore they can get away by saying that is non-existent, they do not understand the flaw that it is same as shunyavada. If they say ajnana is not the karya, then why are we discussing ajnana? If they say that it is not shunyavada, then you throw away ajnana, don't talk about ajnana at all. And they would even claim that we are discussing this based on bhashya. If you are discussing this based on bhashya, same Bhagavan bhashyakara has equated ajnana and maya multiple times in Gita also. Gita Bhashya, you don't have to go further into Upanishads. Gita Bhashya also, there is a statement of equating Ajnana and Maya used in Samanadhikaranyam in the same sentence, Vakya. Samanadhikaranyam has to be understood. So, Vyakrana may be lacking there. Even that may be lacking when you differentiate Ajnana and Maya. Therefore, Ajnana Maya iti cha ekam eva vastu uchyate. And this is the tatparya of the prakriya also, vivarana prakriya. Itham avasthatrayapi maya pratiyate. In this manner, you see manifestation of maya. You have anubhav of maya in all three avasthas. In jagrat avastha, brahma aham na janami. That is the anubhava of maya. Then, swapna entire prapancha is maya. So, maya anubhava is there. In Shushupti, na kinchid avedisham is the maya anubhava. So itham avasthatre api maya pratiyate, does not go away in any of the three avasthas. Ataha sa asadvilakshana. Asadvilakshana can be said even if it is present, is anubhuta in any of the three periods of time, in any of the three avasthas, but here you have maya anubhava in all three avasthas. It continues in the to be there in the present the way it was there earlier. Till the jnana, it continues in future also. So kala treyapi continues unless there is jnanotpatti. After jnanotpatti, maya is badhita. Therefore, asadvilakshana. This sadasadvilakshana maya karyam jagadapi sadasadvilakshanam eva. Maya being sadasadvilakshana, prapancha is also sadasadvilakshana, otherwise said to be mithya. Same thing is meant by saying mithya. Advaita mate sadasadvilakshanam eva vastu mithya iti. Anirvachaniyam iti cha kathyate. So the sadasad vilakshana, short form for that is mithya. Therefore, the translation of mithya as unreal is also not right. Unreal is also for the lack of a better word, just like ignorance. Unreal gives a connotation of completely non-existent. It is not so. Mithya is sadasad vilakshana. So if you want to translate, it will be a phrase. It will not be a single word in English. Anirvachaniyam. Sarasadhyam anirvachaniyam. Cannot be talked about and said to be idamittham. It is sat or asat. And all the purva paksha to advaita is like, no, you have to tell us whether it is sat or asat. We don't want to say. We are saying it is not sat, it is not asat. Because do you ask the shruti, why na iti na iti, why niti niti? So these people who question advaita, Advaita Vedanta learns from Mother Shruti. We learn from our parents. We learn from Shruti of how to explain something. In fact, Keno Upanishad Acharya says, Shruti herself says, we do not know any other way to explain this. How do you explain something to someone who is already that? It is only by negation. You cannot have any other process. Even Maya has brought about as an explanation, and that in that explanation you cannot say is it existent or non-existent. You tell me it has been brought about for an explanation. As long as the explanation is needed, it is sat, considered at the same level of sat as you give the world the satta, not sat as in trikala vaditya sat. So when the questioner asks, that time when he says sat, vyavaharika sat, yes, we say vyavaharika sat. As long as there is pratiti, there is maya karya, same level of maya karya satta should be given to maya. It's karana. Once the maya prapancha is inquired into and goes away, then maya has no existence. Is tuchha. You can say maya is tuchha then, not when you are inquiring and when there is an effect seen. You cannot be in the maya karya and say maya is tuchha. So maya is present, accepted as present, as long as there is an inquiry needed. After inquiry, you can say set it aside. Otherwise, it cannot be translated as unreal. Mithya does not mean unreal, nor does anirvachaniyam mean unreal. Maya also does not mean unreal. Magic, you say that there is nothing called as magic. Okay, whatever is there, you see its effect. That effect is due to something. You go to a magical show. Oh, he used some trickery. That trickery is magic. We are not saying magic has to be some mantra or something. Whatever it is. Oh, it is science. You have to understand it. It is science. That itself is magic. Magical. So, it is not non-existent. You cannot say there is nothing called as magic. Whatever is the karana, which I am unable to understand, and I consider it mystical, you consider scientific. Either way, it is magic. The word is magic. When understood, you can say whatever it is. But before understanding, it is called as magic. You cannot say there is nothing called as magic and reject outright. You know, you have to consider the karya and go by it. Therefore, sarasad vilakshana is mithya, anirvachaniya, that is maya, tasmat, and that itself is ajnana. तस्मात् माया तत्कार्याभ्याम न द्वैतम सिद्ध्येत, द्वैतम न सिद्ध्येत। द्वैता कैनॉट हैव सत्ता, रियल प्रेजेंस। प्रपंच आल्सो इज सरसद विलक्षण मिथ्या। माया तत्कार्यो सरसद विलक्षणत्वात्, सरसद विलक्षणत्वात् मिथ्यात्वमेव, नहि मिथ्या पदार्थेन द्वैत सिद्धिर् भवति। मिथ्या पदार्थ कैनॉट बी काउंटेड। You give its presence there, but it is not at the same level as Sat. You cannot count it as another real existent thing. Is it unreal? No. Is it real? No. What is it? Sarasat Vilakshana. Svapne drishta padarthena yathana dvaita siddhihi tatha mithya maya tatkarya abhyana brahmanas sadvitiyatva siddhihi. So we ask the person who says you, tell me whether Maya is Sat or Asat. We ask him in the Swapna, if he had Dhana, does it have any use here? It doesn't. But did it make you happy there? Did it have utility? Did it bring you something there? Then in Swapna it was real. On waking up it is unreal. Therefore it is, instead of saying that it is Sat and Asat both, which is contradictory, two contradictory terms cannot go together, so we say it is neither Sat nor Asat. What is it cannot be explained. I cannot say it is Sat as well as Asat. Cannot be Sat and Asat together. So Sad Vilakshana, Asad Vilakshana, Sarasad Vilakshana also. Simultaneously not Sat and Asat. Independently not Sat, not Asat. Therefore Sarasad Vilakshana. And it cannot be counted. Your money in Swapna money cannot be counted in waking. You cannot say that I have doubled my money. Similarly, Bhaya, you take the flip side also, Dukkha. The dream lion which woke you up, made you perspire, made you run away in the dream, makes you remain still in waking without running away. So it cannot be considered as real. On waking up, it's gone. But during the Swapna, had some reality. Therefore, Sarasad Vilakshana. Ajnanasya Swashre Vishekatvam. This Ajnana, Maya has said to be present in Shuddha Brahma, Shuddha Chaitanya. Ashraya was Shuddha Chaitanya. Now, Ajnana, what is the Ashraya for Ajnana? It is also Shuddha Chaitanya. Because Ajnana and Maya are interchangeable. Now there is a Purva Paksha here within Vedanta itself. How can there be one Ajnana, Ajnana and Maya be same? How can the Ashraya be Shuddha Chaitanya? So this is looked into. Ajnanasya Ashrayatvam Kim? So Ashraya Vishekatvam. Jiveshwara Vibhaga Shunya Shuddha Brahmashrita Maya शुद्धं ब्रह्म एव आवृणोति गृहाश्रितं तमः यथा गृहं एव आवृणोति तद्वत्। सो नाउ टू थिंग्स आर देयर, व्हाट इज द आश्रय एंड विषय। स्व आश्रय मीनिंग अज्ञानस्य स्व आश्रय, अज्ञानस्य आश्रय, अज्ञान आश्रय। लुकिंग फ्रॉम द अज्ञान इज स्व हियर। व्हाट इज द आश्रय ऑफ अज्ञान एंड व्हाट इज द विषय ऑफ अज्ञान। विषय इज Ajnana has some karya to do. Vikshepa is one, another is avarana. So avarana is upon something. What does it do avarana upon? How does it, not how, what does it veil? Where does it rest and what does it veil? So where does it rest? That is ashrayatvam. And what does it veil is vishayatvam. So, Swashraya Vishekatvam Ajnanasya Jiveshwara Vibhaga Shunya Shuddha Brahma. The Shuddha Brahma which cannot be said to be Jeeva or Ishwara. Maya is said to be Tadashrita. Shuddha Brahma Ashrita. Shuddham Brahma Eva Avrunoti. Resting, taking Ashraya veils that very Brahma. This is the Ajnana Karya, Maya Karya. How? Just like graha shritam tamaha yatha graham eva avrunoti. So tama is a bhava padartha that veils the, tamaha is in the house and it veils the house itself. Ashraya is the house and it veils the house. Similarly, तद्वत् अयमेव स्वाश्रयः स्वविशेषकत्व पक्षः इत्युच्यते. सो वन ऑप्शन इज दिस, दिस इज व्हाट इज सेड टू बी स्वाश्रय विषय, स्वाश्रय एंड स्वविशेषकत्व. दिस इज द पक्ष विच इज द विवरण पक्ष. स्वशब्देन शुद्धं ब्रह्म उच्यते. हियर स्व, व्हेन यू से स्व, अज्ञान इज स्व इफ यू टेक इट एज व्हाट इज इट्स आश्रय, बट हियर स्व आई, इट इज नॉट स्व, इज ब्रह्म. सो लुकिंग फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ब्रह्म और जीव, सो हु इज द आश्रय? इफ यू से अज्ञानस्य स्वस्य आश्रय, देन इट इज अज्ञान, बट हियर स्व इज from the perspective of the one who is doing the inquiry. So I'll correct it. I made a mistake. I'm sorry. So here, swa is, swa shabdena shuddham brahma uchyate. Whether jiva or brahma, so swa is, whatever has avarna is swa. So, and whatever is the ashraya. So here, swa ashraya and swa vishayakatva means, ashraya is also swam. I alone am the ashraya. So here, brahma is to be looked into as aham. So therefore, swam. Swam is, not swam, swam is dhanam. There, if you take it in swam, swam also has the meaning of dhana. Here, swa is swasya. When you say swasya, swasya ashrayatvam. So there, ashrayatvam when you take, then swasya ashrayatvam. If you make the samasa like that, that is easier to understand. Swasya ashrayatvam. So ashrayatva is there for me. Meaning, I am the Ashraya. That's the idea there. So, that I happens to be Brahma. So, Shuddha Brahma is my own Swarupa. So, Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa, Mama Swarupa is the Ashraya. I am the Ashraya of Ajnana and I am the Vishaya also. Now, I am explaining this way because Swa has been used. Therefore, I is a better way to understand this. Now, swashabdena shuddham brahma uchyate. Now, this shuddham brahma becomes the ashraya as well as the vishaya, meaning vishaya for ajnana. So, here it is not ajnana, it means of ajnana, it is for ajnana. For ajnana, what is the vishaya to veil? What does it veil? It veils the same brahma on which it rests. Tadeva brahma ajnana se ashraya bhavati. Tadeva brahma ajnanena avriyate cha. So, it is the ashraya. Same Shuddha Brahma as well as that which is veiled. I don't want to say object, but if you want to say object also, it's fine. It's the object of veiling also. Vishaya of veiling. We'll just say Vishaya of veiling, however you consider Vishaya. So it is the Ashraya of that Ajnana. So therefore, Ashraya, there. Kasya Ashraya, Ajnanasya Ashraya. And Vishaya kaha, ajnana se vishaya kaha, kim bhavati. Vishaya is pullinga, therefore kaha bhavati, but vide pradhanena brahma, napumsakalingi. Therefore, kim bhavati? Vishaya ha brahma bhavati. So, brahma is veiled. Tasmad ajnanam swashreya swavishayakam, swashreya swavishayakam ityuchyate. Therefore, Ajnana is said to be Brahma. So you replace Swa with Brahma now. Ajnanasya Brahmashraya Vishayakatvam. Just so that the earlier erroneous usage that I made, that should not last in memory. It should be replaced. So you have to repeat. Abhyasa has to be there to correct the fault. Ajnanasya Swashraya Vishayakatvam means Ajnanasya Brahmashraya Vishayakatvam. Brahma is the Ashraya for Ajnana. Brahma itself becomes the Vishaya. For Ajnana to veil, to do avarna. And what is Vishayatvam? Avratatvam. That which undergoes avarna, that which can and which goes undergoes avarna is the Vishaya for Ajnana. Sankshepa Sharirika Vivarna Vedanta Muktavalyadvaita Siddhyadvaita Deepikadi Granthesu Ajnanam Swashre Vishayakam Iti Varnitam. So there is a Vivarna Paksha. It was said as Paksha. Swashreya Swavishayakatva Paksha. So Swashreya Vishayakatva Paksha Kasya Sankshepa Shariraka. So Sankshepa Shariraka, a work which does the Sankshepa of the Shariraka Mimamsa Sutra. So Shariraka Sutra or Brahma Sutra. So Sankshepa Brahma Sutra in Sankshepa is Sankshepa Shariraka, Vivarna is the sampradaya that Sringeri onwards they follow this. So Vivarna follows the Panchapadika. Vivarna is Panchapadika. So Panchapadika brings about Vivarna. Vedanta Muktavali, there is another work called Vedanta Muktavali. And there is Advaita Siddhi. All these. So Vedanta Muktavali uses Ekajivavada. Very difficult work to understand. You need a lot of tarka. So this Sankshepa Sharirika Vivarana, if you want to go into details, then we need a lot of tarka basis also, because the analysis is quite deep. Analysis is done through tarka. Vedanta Muktavali. So Vedanta Muktavali uses a lot of Navya Nyaya also. Navya Nyaya is more difficult. So Vedanta Muktavali and Advaita Siddhi. Advaita Siddhi refutes the Dvaita Aropa. So Dvaita Aropa. This is Advaita Siddhi is part of Brihat Prasthanatraya. So they created by Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati. So he refutes using Navya Nyaya itself. So there is a lot of tarka there. And Advaita Deepika also, all these granthas at commentary and sub-commentary levels and original works also, of course, refuting the others who have done Aropa, all those granthas use Ajnana, explain Ajnana as Swashreya Vishaya. Ajnana Swashreya Vishayakam, iti Varnitam. This is one paksha. Other paksha will see as to what is the Ashraya, what is the Vishaya. So Ashrayatva and Vishayatva are separated out. Ajnanasya Ashrayatvam is said to be Jiva. Ajnanasya Ashraya is said to be Jiva. And Ajnana Vishaya is said to be Brahma. This is the Bhamati Paksha. So we look at that as Uktarthe Vachaspati Matam. Vachaspati Matam is Bhamati. Vachaspati Mishra, Bhamati Kara. So his Paksha we look at in the next part. Uktarthe is this Ashraya Vishekattvam Kim Ajnanasya, there Vachaspati Matam, Bhagavan Vachaspati Mishra explains it in a different manner. He says that Ashraya is Jiva, whereas Vishaya is Brahma. So we look at that in the next part. Sukar Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Namu Rupayo Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Rukyatya Nirvana Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramha Tadeva Annamattvanyat Iti Menishchitamati Hi.